agenda for this meeting is the situation in Mali. The agenda is adopted. In accordance with Rule 37 of the Council's Provisional Rules of Procedure, I invite the representative of Mali to participate in this meeting. It is so decided. On behalf of the Council, I welcome His Excellency, Mr. Thierville Dramé, Minister of Foreign Affairs and International Cooperation of Mali. In accordance with Rule 39 of the Council's Provisional Rules of Procedure, I invite Mr. Hamad Saleh Anadif, Special Representative of the Secretary General for Mali and Head of the United Nations Multidimensional Integrated Stabilization Mission in Mali, to participate in this meeting. It is so decided.
Good.
The Security Council will now begin its consideration of item 2 of the agenda. I wish to draw the attention of Council members to document S/2020/223, the report of the Secretary General on the situation of Mali. And I give the floor to Mr. Mohamed Saleh Anadi.
Mr. President, Member of the Council, Mr. Thierville Dramé, Minister of Foreign Affairs in Mali, it is an honor and a great pleasure for me to address you remotely to present the Secretary General's report on Mali at a time when the whole world is facing the COVID-19 pandemic, and to command the technical performance that enable us to have this meeting. Mali is not an exception to the pandemic. The country has recorded, as of today, 56 positive cases, including 2 in MINUSMA and 5 deaths. This has led MINUSMA and the country team to develop a contingency plan with different scenarios, which allows many of us to continue to work from our respective residence and some other for special reason and on involuntary basis to return to their countries of usual residence while working remotely. Mr. President, Member of the Council, as you can see, despite this exceptional condition, MINUSMA continues to fulfill the mission entrusted to it by your Council. This, in accordance with Resolution 4280, which I assigned MINUSMA to prioritize, namely, the implementation of the Agreement for Peace and Reconciliation in Mali and supporting the political framework for the management of the crisis in the center, notably the protection of civilians, the reduction in intercommunity violence, the strengthening of the presence of state, and the return of basic social services. As part of the implementation of the agreement and as a result of the impetus provided by the holding of the National Inclusive Dialogue, I am pleased to report the following. 1, the redeployment of the first reconstituted units of the Malian Defense and Security Forces in North, notably in Gao, Timbuktu, Kidal, and Menaka, has become a reality with more than 1,000 elements deployed since February 2020. 2, the Prime Minister's visit to the North region, notably to Kidal, Tessalit, and Agelot, is a demonstration of trust building among the signatory parties to the agreement. 3, The Agreement Monitoring Committee has resumed its activity, unlike the Inter-Malian Framework, whose activities are slowing down. Four, the high-level workshop on the inclusion of women was held and enjoyed strong participation. Five, the first round of legislative election was conducted in peaceful atmosphere despite the kidnapping of the leader of the opposition, Soumaïla Cissé, 3 days before election day. At the national level, the third quota for women has been respected. With regard to the center, a second strategic priority of the United Nations, MINUSMA continues to implement its adaptation plan. A total of 19 additional civil staff have already been redeployed to Mopti. As part of MINUSMA's efforts to respond to early warnings, a hotline has been established in Mopti to serve the civilian population. The force continues Operation Buffalo for better protection of civilians and has established temporary operating bases around sensitive localities. With the support of MINUSMA, the Malian authority have continued to conduct dialogue and reconciliation initiative. The consultation framework of the Permanent Secretariat for the Management of the Crisis held a series of meetings in Mopti with local authority, civil society, and representatives of the Dogon and the Fulani from Bandiagara, Bankas, Duenza, and Kor. The Prime Minister's visit sent out a strong signal by ordering the dismantling of checkpoints illegally installed by militia along the main Mopti Bankas road. It is to be hoped that concrete action to fight impunity will be taken as the number of displaced persons continue to increase. Mr. President, Member of the Council, in terms of regional security cooperation, MINUSMA continues to provide logistical support to the G5 Sahel Joint Force. In this context, I am pleased to inform you that the construction work and the Joint Force headquarters in Bamako has started. Mr. President, Member of the Council, lastly, I would like to highlight the exemplary cooperation that has been established between the United Nations system in Mali and the government is fighting against the COVID-19 pandemic. Since 19 March, commercial flights to Mali have been suspended. Group gatherings are prohibited, and curfew has been introduced from 9 p.m. to 5 a.m. However, MINUSMA and the country team continue to fulfill their mandates while complying with government decision. Thus, by decision of Secretary General, the rotation of armed contingent is suspended until 30 June 2020. However, exception may be envisaged for the implementation of the mandate with authorization on a case-by-case basis and respecting isolation period and other guidelines to prevent the spread of the virus. Staff with medical condition or wishing to join their families have been given the opportunity to do so using special flight requests by some embassies and authorized by the government. Mr. President, Member of the Council, This is a brief account of the situation of evolution, the situation on Mali. As you can see, we face many challenges, including the safety and well-being of the whole UN family in Mali, but also have real hopes through the capacity of resilience of the Malian people. Thank you for your attention.
I thank Mr. Anadi for his briefing. This concludes our live broadcast of this meeting.